Now, here's important places for us to take this out of the Bible and bring it into real life. Because the truth is, the Tower of Babel is not just a story in the scriptures, it's our story too. And the church said, amen. We hear and see it in the divisive rhetoric that has become so prevalent in our country and around our world right now. It's scary what we're hearing, and more scary is what it's emboldened in people in their actions and their violence. We bow down to the evil temptation of self-idolatry when we seek to make a name for ourselves. And we get so homogeneic in our sense of who belongs in and who we keep out that we believe that our strength is so strong that we build militarized walls around ourselves to say to other people, you ain't welcomed here. That's Tower of Babel thinking. Do you hear me? That type of mentality causes us then to say that justice is not justice and liberty for all. It now becomes justice is just for us. Justice, just us. And so every good thing is just for us. That means anything that's worth having belongs to us. That if I want to live here, we're going to stay here because this place was for us. And now that kind of prevalent thinking leads to the horror that we saw in Charlottesville, Virginia, just yesterday. This is not an ancient story. This is a real life story. That type of mentality that somehow justifies violence and rhetoric that divides and builds walls around and keeps people in and tell other people that they're out. That's what leads to white supremacy. And it's that kind of thinking that started a complete mob riot where people were killed by someone who felt justified in their belief in their supremacy over others to point their finger and say, this belongs to us. And then mow down innocent people in the street who had the nerve to be standing in belief that it was supposed to be liberty and justice for all.